En los deportes de la página informativa, enciende O'Neill, la máquina deportiva. En los deportes tú acabó con tu, la máquina deportiva, line.com.
Hockey, fútbol, lucha libre, compatá, baloncesto, béisbol, boxeo y mucho más. Las noticias del deporte bien actualizado, entrevista y opinión y todos los resultados. O'Neill Batista anotó un touchdown, batiendo 400 te de gano, que que Kobe Bryant, él está donkeando la máquina deportiva. A mí me está gustando.
En los deportes de la página informativa, enciende O'Neill, la máquina deportiva. En los deportes tú acabó con todo, la máquina deportiva, live.com.
¡Hawaya! Esta es la máquina deportiva. O'Neill Batista, mete mano. Vamos al perreo. Aguacate.
Saludo cordial a todos los que sintonizan la máquina deportiva Postcard. Yo soy O'Neill Batista, como siempre, placer inmenso de compartir con todos ustedes. Tenemos informaciones en Grandes Ligas. El dominicano Michael Pineda regresó de una gran suspensión. Tuvo una gran labor en el montículo, sólida. Entrada para Minnesota en un triunfo de 6-2 sobre los Tigres de Detroit. Pineda permitió 2 carreras y 3 hits con 8 ponches y 2 bases por bola en su primera victoria desde el 1 de septiembre del año pasado 2019. Después cumplió una suspensión de 60 partidos por consumir una sustancia para perder peso. El dominicano reapareció sin decisión la semana pasada con labor de 6 episodios. En la victoria de Minnesota sobre Chicago. El derecho tiene una efectividad de 2.77 en 2 aspiraciones y mantiene el nivel que mostró el año pasado, acumulando una floja de 7.71 y una efectividad de 2.6 y 73 ponches en sus últimas 11 aperturas previa a la suspensión. El lanzador cuenta por detrás de la banda del jardinero. Las noticias para el equipo de los Azulejos de Toronto. El jardinero Toscar Hernández de los Azulejos está en la lista de lesionados. Movimiento retroactivo al sábado debido a un tirón en el obículo izquierdo. Hernández fue sentado por Toronto tanto el domingo como el lunes mientras el equipo espera el diagnóstico. En 39 partidos en el 2020, Hernández lleva promedio de 3.08, 14 jonrones, un OPS de 95. Esperemos la pronta recuperación para Toscar Hernández. Quédate en casa para reducir el riesgo de contagio. Mantén al menos 6 pies de distancia entre los demás y tu prueba de tensión, distanciamiento social, fiebre, tos, dolor de garganta o dificultad para respirar. Sexo, edad o distrito, no importa. Para el coronavirus, la vacuna eres tú. Tenemos a Aaron Hit y a AJ Hart, el jardinero y lanzador de los Yankees de Nueva York, conversando con nosotros en la prensa. Así que lo dejamos con AJ Hart y Aaron Hit.
Hey Jay, when you look at that Blue Jays lineup, what are some of the challenges that they present?
Well, I think you're seeing kind of what they've been hoping for over the last few years. A lot of young players with a lot of energy, and they're definitely turned into big league players. They're having success. You got power and speed and the ability to create some havoc on the base path. So, obviously they're feeling pretty good too, because they've been winning ball games, moved into second place here. So we got to try to take some of that from them.
Understanding the goal is always to put up zeros, but do you feel additional pressure to be perfect when the offense isn't producing, knowing that you probably will not be getting a lot of run support?
I think you certainly try not to. I think, the game is the game and you adjust in game how the game's gone as far as your attack and things like that and how you attack different hitters. But that's just part of the game and there's ebbs and flows. And, I think we have the capability to definitely break out, hopefully sooner than later.
NJ, how would you just describe the state of the team right now, given the recent struggles?
I think we're anxious to try to put those behind us. I think we're anxious to start winning ball games more consistently, playing better more consistently. I think we know we have the people in here to do that. So obviously that's going to be our goal every day.
Thank you. We'll take the next one from Sweeney Murdy.
Jay, seeing a team 10 times in 18 days means a lot of looks at the same arms. What are the challenges there, not just for starters, but for relievers as well?
Yeah, that's interesting how this played out. You know, I just came from facing the same, from starting at same team twice. And, you know, I kind of mentioned I try not to look too deep into that as far as that second time around. I don't know. I think we got to keep that. I think we just got to focus day at a time. You know, I think if we get too caught up in that, then, you know, that could paralyze us a little bit. But, you know, hopefully on the offensive end on our side, we can take some advantage as well.
You just try to focus on your strengths, or are you always kind of tinkering based on what you're seeing from, you know, one game or one at bat?
Yeah, I mean, generally focus on your strengths, but definitely, I mean, over the course of, if we happen to, you know, if you're a starter and you're facing these guys 2-3 times over the next couple of weeks, or a reliever facing them a bunch, I think you're going to get an idea of what you're seeing. So, you know, you definitely try to use some of those things if something's glaring, for sure.
Thanks, Jay.
Sure.
Next one goes to Eric Boland.
Jay, realizing you haven't taken the mound in this ballpark yet, I'm just curious what you think pitching in a minor league ballpark. What are your impressions of Benavid so far?
Yeah, just being out there this afternoon, it seemed like another ballpark. So, you know, I think they did a fine job in preparing it. You know, we'll take the field, and I think we'll play as if, you know, it's regular field here, Major League Baseball field. So, you know, I don't know my impressions yet. I'll have to see kind of how the ball's flying tonight and, you know, surface and all that. But from what I see, it looks good.
There's been a lot of, since the Blue Jays, you know, started here as their home, there's been a lot of home runs. Have you, you know, seen any of those scores? Do you have any, you know, thoughts on that? It seems like the ball does carry pretty well here.
I hear some people talking about it. That's sort of the talk, is that the ball travels pretty well. That's what I've heard. I haven't paid particular attention to it, but there's some scuttlebutt about that.
Thank you, Jake.
Yeah.
Next one to Christy Ackert.
Hi, Jay. I know you guys go back to minor league games for rehab assignments and stuff like that, but what is it kind of like to come back to a stadium like this in a town that you guys don't come to very regularly? Is it a little strange?
It is strange. You know, they did a nice job here with our clubhouse, and it's kind of a big tent out here. It sort of feels like we're potentially in a big tournament of some kind or something. But it's kind of just, you know, par for 2020. We're rolling with it, and you know, hopefully we can play well here. We're excited to try to kind of put the last few weeks behind us and try to kind of turn a page here.
Thank you.
Welcome. Any other questions for Jay? Jay, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Meredith, please unmute.
Hey, Aaron, was there any kind of meeting or anything today heading into the series just based on the way you guys have struggled over the last week or two?
No, there was no meeting. We just had a regular hitters meeting. Can you hear me? All right.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. Just a regular hitters meeting and kind of trying to talk to our Marcus, just trying to tell us just to relax and be ourselves. And, you know, and we just need to produce, and we definitely are the team that can do that.
Has that been difficult to do, knowing that time is ticking away, to relax and try to be yourself at the plate?
Yeah. I mean, you know, we only got 3 weeks to do this, and, you know, I believe that we believe that we're still a team that can do this. You know what I mean? We're just not producing right now, and we're a team that's used to producing, used to being at the top of all the charts and runs and all that stuff. But, you know, we're just not doing it, and I believe we can be.
Take the next one from Christy Ackert.
Hey, Aaron. Aaron Boone said yesterday that you felt you guys were really pressing when you were up at the plate as a team. Did you feel like you were pressing a little bit yesterday and feeling the pressure?
I mean,
I know you had the pinch.
I pinched it yesterday. Not really. I feel like I'm not. I mean, I've been pressing, yes, definitely. But I mean, I feel like yesterday I felt good. I felt like I was seeing the ball well. Right-handed against that one at bat, and I got that hit. And lefty, I just kind of just went out of the zone. But you know, I mean, I definitely feel like as a team, yeah, we have been pressing because we want to score runs and we want to win games, and we just want that one blowout, you know, game where it's just absolutely out of reach, and we just haven't been able to do that.
What do you think takes, you know, what does it take to turn that page from yesterday, a series in Baltimore? What will it take?
I just understand we're playing a new team, and understand today is a new day, and that we need to just focus on today, focus one at a bat at a time, and do what we can as hitters to make sure that we have great at bats throughout the whole lineup, and I think we'll do just fine.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Next one goes to Pete Caldera.
Aaron, last year when Didi Gregorius was coming back from Tommy John surgery, it seemed like he had, you know, it was a struggle to sustain offensively at times. I'm just wondering if there's, in your recovery, have you found that just coming back from that surgery, is that, does that impact your hitting to this point now, or how's that been working for you?
I would say, yeah. I mean, it does affect your hitting because you just get sore out of nowhere. You can be playing a game and, you know, and out of nowhere you just get sore and it doesn't feel so great. And you can go out to the outfield or infield or whatever and make a throw, and all of a sudden, you know, it's not feeling that great. And but it's stuff that we just have to deal with, and you know, it's just a part of it.
Take the next one from Sweeney Murdy.
Aaron, would you say that affected? You're in the field too, whether it's, you know, thinking about making throws or certain throws that you have made?
No, I mean, if I have an opportunity to try to make that throw, I'm just going to just make it. I'm not going to really think too much about it. Because I've made throws like that, and, you know, it hasn't really felt great. And then the next day I feel really good. So, you know, it, for me, I'm just, you know, just pretty much just taking it day by day, and understanding that I'm not going to be 100% every single day like I would if I had, you know, a year and a half from Tommy John. So, but it's just, it is what it is.
And one more. Last year there was, you know, the whole next man up mentality, and even though you guys lost a lot of people, you know, you were still able to perform, put runs on the board. Has it been any more difficult? Does it feel any different this year that you still have a lot of big bats out of the lineup? Is there anything you can put your finger on as to why it might be a different battle this year?
I mean, you know, now the league happens to know these guys, you know, now people are starting to realize who these guys are coming up, and we're still having new guys come in. I mean, we started two rookies in the Orioles series. I mean, it's like, it's pretty awesome to be have depth like that, especially when in situations like this where everybody's just going down. And but I mean, at the end of the day, we have to go out there and win with who we got.
Take the next one from Brian Hoke.
Hey, Aaron. Just wondering what your impressions are of that ballpark in Buffalo. We've heard like the dressing area is a little different than what you guys might be used to.
Yeah, similar to the London series. You know, kind of plastic everywhere. Yeah, it's just different, you know, but it's very similar to the London series. And as far as the field, I haven't even seen the field yet, so I don't know if any changes have happened there yet.
We'll take the next one from Eric Boland.
Aaron, you've played with Gary Sanchez for a few years now. You've seen him at his best. How surprised are you to see the offensive struggles that he's had so far, given the past success that he's had at the plate?
I mean, it's definitely tough to watch him kind of go through this. But, I mean, it's all about being able to make adjustments and make adjustments quick, you know, especially in this game. You know, once they kind of figure out something that you're doing or something you're swinging at, you gotta understand what they're trying to do and make the adjustment. So it's been tough, but I still believe that he's still gonna continue to do his thing coming up here in the next 3 weeks and get back on track.
Thank you, Aaron.
Yeah. Are there any other questions for Aaron? George King, please unmute.
Aaron, when a team is going bad like your team is now, you know, you hear the manager's fault, the coach's fault, but would you agree that the onus really falls on the players now? There's only so much.
We're not doing our job. Our job is to win ball games. Our job is to go out there and score runs and prevent runs. So the only way we can start with that is starting to do our job, and our job is as players is to go out there and produce, and we haven't been able to do that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Neftali, do you have a question? Please unmute.
Adam, in the way you got to look at it right now, what are you thinking you got as a group? That you got as a group make it any kind of meeting to see what kind of adjustment you have to do it as a group, try to win in some games. And every game is important to win. But how important is for you guys to win tonight?
I think it's very important to win ball games. I think I might know what you're talking about. Did you say what do we have to do as a group to win?
I say if you guys do it at any kind of meeting as a group, try to see where you guys have to adjust to make a more improvement to win the games.
I mean, we just have to score runs. We have to score runs. As hitters, I mean, I can't talk for what our pitchers are doing, but we have to score runs. We have to when we got guys in scoring position, we have to get them in, you know, by any means necessary, and try to figure out different ways to do that.
Okay, thank you, Aaron. Appreciate the time.
Yeah.
Ubicado en el 2257 de la Segunda Avenida y calle 116 en el corazón del barrio, y el otro en el 1618 de San Nicolás y calle 191 en el centro del Alto Manhattan. En los nuevos Calidad Restaurant disfrutará de un menú variado y económico, y a la vez puede apreciar un museo de béisbol con fotos históricas. En los nuevos Calidad Restaurant tenemos delivery gratis. Visítelos hoy.
De liga, el outfield, el jardinero de los Rockies de Colorado, Raimel Tapia, se convierte en titular de uno de los del equipo Colorado del 2019. Tapia asegura ser un buen primer bat. Llegó a Grandes Ligas con los Rockies en el 2016 con las herramientas indicadas para ser un buen primer bate, pero al dominicano le tomó un tiempo para hallar la manera de hacer sentir en el tope de la alineación. Tapia, de 26 años, se convierte en el titular de los jardineros de Colorado la temporada pasada, entre el 11 de agosto del 2019 y el sábado. El oriundo de San Pedro de Macorís batea con 3.46 con un porcentaje de envasarse de 3.48 antes de irse de 5.3 el domingo en la victoria de los Rockies de Colorado sobre los Dodgers. Desde el pasado 20 de agosto, Tapia ha visto 442 picheos. Por lo visto, por la visita del plato. En el sexto mayor promedio de la Liga Nacional, según Tatis. Corporation. Ha sido un cambio dramático. El año pasado fue sustituido entonces por primer bate Charlie Blackman. Tapia tuvo promedio 2.55, porcentaje de envasarse de apenas 2.86 en los 86 visitas al plato en dicho papel. Después de eso, el quiqueyano fue bajado en orden de bateo. ¿Qué ha cambiado? En la consistencia de tener más turnos, sentirse como cómodo y estar enfocado. Mucha práctica, dijo Tapia. El manager Blue Black afirma que Tapia ha hecho un ajuste mental. La campaña pasada tuvo 9 jonrones, uno de los dentro del parque y 28 extra base, siendo la gran mayoría en casa. Cool frío. Trata de constituir en base de esos resultados el problema. No puede tener dos mentalidades diferentes, una para la casa, otra para la ruta, dijo Blackman. Entonces creo que tiene un compromiso con ser la clase de bateador de todo esperamos que puede ser. Usarle todo el terreno, poner la bola en juego y negociar sus bases por bola y no tirar a los picheos malos. Toque femenino en la máquina deportiva lo pone Madeline Soler en los resultados de la NBA.
Hola, ¿qué tal, amigo? Una vez más, su servidora Magdalene Soler. Y es que la semifinal de la NBA sigue bastante reñida, ya que Boston Celtics vuelve a la carga ganando 111-89 a los Raptors de Toronto, colocando el marcador 3-2 a tan solo una victoria para avanzar a la siguiente ronda en los playoffs. Mientras que Los Ángeles Clippers derrotan 113-107 a Denver, donde la actuación de Powell con 32 puntos y Leonardo con 23 puntos ponen a los Clippers adelante. Esto fue todo por hoy en su programa La Máquina Deportiva.
Mi gente, como siempre, hemos llegado a la parte final de este programa de La Máquina Deportiva Postcard. La invitación siempre sigue abierta para nuestro próximo postcard y que pásenla bien, que Dios los bendiga.
Sigue vacilando lo nuevo de Moreno Negrón y esto va en exclusiva para La Máquina Deportiva. ¡Suscríbete! Después le brindé dos. Luego del picapollo me dijo:
ok, tato. Tato, 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 tato.
¿Cómo?
Ok, tato. Tato, 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 tato.
Dale otra vez.
Tato, 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 tato.
Suena otra vaina.
Tato, 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 tato.
Dale, mambo.
Sigue vacilando lo nuevo de Moreno Negrón. Esto va en exclusiva para La Máquina Deportiva. Esa mujer nada más piensa en eso. Yo no me explico.
Moreno Negrón.
Se estaba cotizando y yo estaba sudando. No se daba cuenta que me estaba sofocando. Volvió y dijo que no, contigo yo no mango. Pero en menos de un minuto me estaba chupando el mango.
Wow.
Ok, tato. Tato, 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 tato. Tato, 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 tato.
Dile otra vez.
Tato, 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 tato.
Súbelo, súbelo.